Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed.
I knew I had too much to drink tonight. Maybe it was the last shot I'd practically been force-fed, which now bubbled unsteadily in my stomach. That was the dead giveaway. I'm one hiccup from spilling my guts into the shrubs that line the cobblestone street. My knees wobble beneath the dingy pub sign, a blur of swimming neon colors and sculpted bricks. I rummage around in the sticky depths of my purse with clumsy, limp fingers. For some reason, my fuzzy brain thinks it's super funny that all I can seem to find are ripped concert stubs and gas station receipts. Where the fuck are my keys? I'm dragging one palm against a light post to steady my jumbled steps when wait. I feel the torrent of sweat behind my neck turn to ice as what I can only describe in my very inebriated state as a floating head dart behind a tree. I plop onto the curb, massaging my temple. From across the puddle-ridden pavement lies a stretch of patchy dark woods. The slender trunks have practically swallowed their sidewalk barrier and rusty road signs. A bloated deposit of dead autumn leaves collects in the gutter. A twinge of cheap bar fries climbs into my throat. I swallow, cursing my friends for abandoning me at the first sign of no-string sex. A gust of wind rustles the spindly tree branches. That was definitely a head, yep. I stagger to my feet, watching the black mass bob between low-hanging limbs. It creeps behind a fallen tree where it leans into a pocket of moonlight, still shrouded just beyond the street. My heart is thumping wildly in my ears. I fidget with the purse strap on my shoulder. The shadow stomps through a rotted log, one foot stepping onto the gravel path shit. I stumble past the stop sign, half dragging my throbbing ankles through the motions. My chunky black stilettos click, click, click. I pause beneath a rickety store awning. A dull orange glow emits from the flickering streetlight. I watch the shadow crouch behind a dead flower bush. Only the white glow of his eyes flares in the darkness. Somehow, I overly convince myself that the cloaked figure isn't stalking me, despite the fact that the only life forms on this desolate road are the hunter and its wounded prey, and I know the thing is watching me. Above me, moths buzz against the only torch in the thick black night. It blinks three times, then fizzles out. My scalp prickles. I teeter past a shut-up pawn shop as the sole of my heel gets absorbed by a chunky piece of gum. Seriously? Nausea crawls into my throat. My calf muscles ripple and stiffen. I tug at the swallowed shoe, watching oogie strands of Hubba Bubba stretch and harden. I think I'm about to dislodge my ruined footwear when something possesses me to sneak a glance over my shoulder. Call it the drunken will to survive, maybe. I quickly scan the tree line, nothing but the abandoned line of foliage. I'm almost certain I imagine the whole thing, already coming up with a witty story to tell the roommates when a shadow emerges from a nearby alleyway. Half leaning against a dumpster a few blocks back, head tipped down, cloaked by a hoodie, its silhouette twitches, tiptoeing through cigarette butts. I decide to abandon my shoe, falling into a jog down the jagged sidewalk. The hollow click, click, click of my uneven footing seems to echo into the stars. My bag slips off my shoulder. As I clamber over a pothole, I desperately dig for the smooth metal of my keyring. Blood rushes into my ears. I turn again. The figure is twisted under the extinguished lamppost with its neck wrenched so far up that I can only see a glimmer of its exposed collarbone. I walk faster, tripping over a dilapidated fire hydrant. I lurch past a rundown flower shop, heart battering the insides of my ribcage. I can just begin to see the slopes of my apartment complex's roof rise over the tops of the vacant buildings. I hop over a broken beer bottle, swaying past the greasy traffic cone. The night seemed to devour me whole, except for my anguished gasps and empty click, click, click of my remaining stiletto. I grip white-knuckled to a decaying building edge. My lungs burn white-hot for oxygen. I quickly flip around, terrified of what may be waiting for me. Sure enough, on the corner I just crossed, maybe 20 feet away, it's there. Head cocked into the moonlight, casting shadows over the shape of a crooked nose, the peaks of a jutting chin. I run, abandoning the other shoe in a rain puddle, raw, bare feet whopping against concrete, sweat pooling in the folds of my thighs. I glance again over my shoulder, almost crying out at the sight of the veiled figure just a few feet behind me, hunched over, practically grazing the back of my arm. I'm sprinting now, pummeling against the street. My purse slips, Mickey tumbles out, but I don't stop. I can't. Not when I can feel their rancid breath assault the nape of my neck and whose heavy footfalls keep time with my own. One more block separates this hunt from the safety of my apartment door. I can practically feel my fingers pressing into the grooves of my entry handle. I sidestep an abandoned bicycle, heels digging into rough gravel chunks. My stomach flips. So close. A crunch of broken glass as my pursuer pushes my back with calloused hands. I break into a sprint, frantically hurling myself through the street. the sickening symphony of my choked sobs snuffed out by the stranger's menacing chase. I see the ornate gold outline of my apartment number and the little rock I keep the spare key under. Almost. My lungs scream. I'm panting and heaving in the cool night air. The stranger is right behind me, rousing my baby hair with seething sighs. In a last-ditch effort, I swing my practically empty purse in their general direction. They easily fling it aside, grappling a fistful of my hair and yanking me to the ground. Vomit slithers onto my tongue, watching the figure hover above me. I've been waiting for this for quite some time. The voice is methodical, vaguely familiar. The motion sensor light bathes the stranger as they slowly unfurl their fingers and withdraw the hood over starched blonde hair. I can hardly catch my breath. Their hair tickles my nostrils as they slowly lean down to face our mirrored green eyes and chiseled features, and I'm gazing into the face of me.